our universe, a vast and mystical place, yet full of mystery. How big is it? Why are we here? Is there a higher being up there? To answer these, we first got to look deep within ourselves, really, really deep, to what makes us, and ultimately, the universe. At the universal domain of tininess, these are quantum foams atop one-dimension strings, the fabric of space-time itself, going any smaller would defy the laws of physics. This is the smallest thing in existence, a Planck particle. The next smallest thing are quintillion times bigger. Everything in our universe are made up of these particles defined by the standard model. They are responsible for mass, electromagnetism, gravity, and radioactive decay. The smallest of them is the electron neutrino, so small it fades against even the smallest quark. These are quarks which combine to form composite particles, the most familiar being the protons and neutrons. This wave is from the photon, the light particle. Zooming further, we pass by the electrons and reach the Higgs boson, the particle responsible for mass. And finally, we made it to what we're all familiar with, protons and neutrons, some of which combine to form atomic nucleus, the largest being element 118. Yet, the nucleus is a tiny fraction of the atom. Electrons in quantum motion orbits this vast empty space, and at last, the atom. Big, huh? Our body alone is made up of 1 octillion atoms, with cesium being the largest. Some of these bond to form the 4 building blocks of life, proteins, carbohydrates, fats, and DNA. The wonders of nanotechnology exist here. This is a typical view of an electron microscope. The land here is ruled by viruses, so small yet deadly. For example, HIV claims millions annually. We zoom out to bacteria. Our body alone has an astonishing 100 trillion of them. These are cells that make up life. Every single one of our 40 trillion cells contains 20 billion pairs of DNA genome. We reach the landscape of some of the smallest animals. At this scale, even a flea looks like something straight off a horror movie. Ugh. A rice grain and an ant. We're getting more familiar. Oh, would you look at that genius channel advertisement on the iPhone? And here is your daily dose of nightmare. Enjoy. Do be grateful they didn't grow as big as us.
And this is where we stand, created by the very laws of the macroscopic world, to create the vast macroscopic world beyond us. Marvel at the fascinations of the animal kingdom, and its biggest land mammal, the elephant.
Yet, the ocean dwells even larger creatures. For example, the giant squid, the Jurassic World mosasaur, and a blue whale, the largest animal ever existed. But history produced even greater creatures. A jet-sized flying creature, a dinosaur longer than a blue whale, and another taller than a five-story building. Still dwarf in comparison to the tallest living organism, the Hyperion tree. But we scale higher with aerodynamic technology. And behold, the largest thing to ever flew the skies, the Hindenburg. We have also conquered the seas with naval technology. Behold, the Poseidon of the sea, Jarl Viking. And we've reached higher than ever, building architectural masterpieces towering city skylines, even exceeding natural wonders. We've not only exceeded vertically, but horizontally as well. Yet nature always outdo us, forming landforms reaching incredible heights.
But our species spread wide and far. Yet space is a whole new frontier. These are the moons of other planets, vast areas of unexplored regions, climate and landscape awaits. As we zoom out from moons to planets, we ask ourselves, where are we? That's here. That's Earth. On it, everyone you ever know, every religion, every ideology, every conflict, every experience, every saint and sinner in history of our species live out their lives in a speck of dust, suspended in space. The sun, a ball of superheated gas, can fit a million Earth inside of it. Yet our sun is tiny compared to the really big stars out there. Polaris, over 10,000 times bigger than our sun. Pistol star, 3,000 times larger than Polaris. If it was our sun, it would have reached far out as Mars. And then there's this monster, UY-SKYSY, the largest star ever discovered, a billion times bigger than our sun. The extent of our solar system. Yet, it's just one of many solar systems in our galaxy, one of them being the TRAPPIST-1 star system, believed to house 7 planets with life. Passing by Saturn orbit, witness the largest black hole, an abyss among these interstellar beauties. We've reached the distance light travels in a year, just reaching the nearest stars. At this scale, a space shuttle would take hundreds of millions of years to cover. These spectacular objects you see are called nebulas. There are interstellar regions of clouds and stardust. The largest and probably most boring name one being this, NGC 604. But they are accompanied by stars, lots of them. Some have dozens of planets. As we traverse our Milky Way, could there be someone, somewhere out there, among billions of stars and trillions of planets, thinking, do we exist? Our Milky Way, home to 100 billion stars, our sun being just one of them. It's just one of trillions of galaxies out there, each with billions of stars.
And some are really, really big. IC-1101, the largest galaxy. It contains 100 trillion stars and 1 quadrillion planets. Could there be one with life? Galaxies merge to form galaxy clusters.
Each speck you see here is not a single star, but a whole galaxy of stars, seen as one. Laniakea, a supercluster of 100,000 galaxies. In just one of many superclusters in the Physis-Zeta supercluster complex, with many other supercluster complex, formed a vast cosmic web. And eventually, our universe. Here lies everything. Or does it? What if there's a universe, one where Hillary Clinton became president, one where Hitler won the war, or the dinosaur never went extinct? What if there are parallel universes with different timelines? How many would there be? A lot. In just 1 second, anything could happen. This is the number of parallel universes in the next second alone. A number so big it's just a number of digits in half. Anything from your crush texting you now to this video hangs happens here.
Yet, since the Big Bang, unimaginable numbers of parallel universes have formed. Every possible event imaginable, every alternate timeline conceivable.
Everything within the laws of physics, every possible outcome throughout all of space-time itself exists here. Parallel universe. Yet, could there even be other parallel universe with different laws of physics, other dimensions, and even colors we can't see? Alternate universe with everything we can't ever imagine nor comprehend. The multiverse.